Okay, soon we'll be building a 3-inch micro. And of course, we're going to need a frame. But with so many options out there, how do we go about choosing the right one? What are some of the important things that we need to consider in choosing a frame before we punch that buy button? Today, we're going to be looking at some of the most important things to consider when choosing a frame for your 3-inch micro build by looking at those important things on two different frames and comparing them one to another. So by the end of this video, you'll have a good understanding of what to look for in an FPV frame, and we've put together a little guide, which you can grab in the video description below, of those important things, so you don't have to remember them. And by using it, you'll be able to compare at least 27 different frames in a matter of just a few short minutes. And if you don't mind, we'd appreciate it if you stuck around until the end, because we've got a decision to make, and we'd like your input in making it. These are the two frames we're going to use as examples to walk through the process of comparing parameters of different frames. This one is the FlexRC Ascent HD. And this is the HDLRC Aero 3 Hybrid. What's unique about this frame just came out, is the distance between the two front arms is narrower than the distance between the two back arms. That's why it's called a hybrid. And these are the parameters that we're going to be taking a look at when we're walking through the process with our two frames. The first one being the wheelbase, or the diagonal motor-to-motor distance, which is the actual size of the frame. Second one is weight. The weight of the frame is going to be a big factor in determining the quadcopter's thrust to weight ratio, because the weight of the frame is actually one of the biggest contributors to the overall weight of the quad. The motor mounting pattern, what size motors can the frame support? Is the mounting pattern 9x9 or 12x12, basically, for these micro 3-inch frames. The flight stack mount pattern, is it holding a 20x20 micro stack, or is it the standard 30.5 by 30.5 millimeter stack, which most mini quads have? In addition to that, we're going to take a look at the number of stacks the frames can actually withhold. Is it going to be a single stack, a dual stack, or at least one frame out there I'm aware of has the ability to hold triple stacks? We're also going to take a look at the max stack height, the actual space in the frame to hold the flight stack from the bottom of the top plate, or the side plate, if there is no top plate, to the top of the base plate. Also, as an indicator of frame durability, we're going to be taking a look at the thickness of the frame, the base plate, as well as the arms and the side and top plates, because the thickness of the carbon or the material used in these different parts of the frame will actually be a big factor in determining what the frame's durability will be. We're going to take a look at the type of camera the frame can support. Is it going to be a micro type camera, 19 by 19, or a mini or a standard size camera? And of course, one of the factors to consider when before purchasing any frame will be the cost. Okay, the first parameter that we're going to look at on both of these frames is going to be the wheelbase, or the diagonal motor-to-motor distance, the actual size of the frame. So on the FlexRC Ascent, we're going to measure it from the center of motor mount. And this is coming in at right at 153 millimeters. And for the HDLRC Aero 3 Hybrid, we are getting right at 152 millimeters. We want to take a look at the weight of both of these frames. FlexRC Ascent is coming in at 30 grams. And the HDLRC Aero is coming in at a beefy 44 grams. That's almost 50%. That's just about 50% more weight on the HDLRC Aero than you have on the FlexRC Ascent, which obviously, if you use the same components for each, is going to affect its thrust to weight ratio. This is going to have a greater thrust to weight ratio
than the HDLRC aero if you use the exact same components for each. Next, we're going to look at the motor mounting pattern, which is going to determine the size of the motors that these two frames can hold. And you can see here on the FlexRC Ascent, these are not circular holes. These are actual slots, which means that you can mount different size motors on this particular frame. The same is true for this HDLRC Aero 3 hybrid frame. These are slots, which makes both of these frames versatile with regards to the types of motors that they can hold. As you can see, this can hold, this is a 9x9 millimeter mounting pattern minimum, and it can go up to a 12x12 millimeter mounting pattern, which means that this frame theoretically can run 11XX to 15XX motors or any motor with a 12x12 mount. Similarly, the same is true for the HDLRC Aero 3 hybrid. We'll now take a look at the mounting pattern for the flight stack. On the FlexRC Ascent, as you can see, this holds 20 by 20, but wait, it also looks like it holds the standard 30.5 by 30.5 as well. For the HDLRC Aero 3 hybrid, this has a 20 by 20 flight stack mounting pattern. Of course, also we need to take a look at the number of stacks both of these frames can hold. And for both the FlexRC Ascent and the HDLRC Aero, as you can see, they're only designed to hold one stack. So what about the stack height? As we mentioned earlier, we're going to measure that from the top of the base plate to the bottom of the side plates, or in the case of the HDLRC Aero, the bottom of the top plate. So from the top of the bottom plate to the bottom of the side plate, we are getting 33 millimeters, which also means this FlexRC Ascent can actually hold four boards. The HDLRC Aero 3 hybrid, from the top of the bottom plate to the bottom of the top plate, we are getting 25 millimeters. We're going to take a look at the frame thickness, the base plates, and obviously the arm thickness for the FlexRC Ascent, because it's one piece. It's coming in at 2.5 millimeters. And the arm thickness for the HDLRC Aero 3 is coming in at approximately 4 millimeters. These sandwich plates, looks like they're 2 millimeters. The side plates for the FlexRC Ascent, coming in at 1.8 millimeters, approximately 2 millimeters. No side plates on the Aero. These camera protection plates are coming in at 1.3 millimeters. And the top plate for the Aero is coming in at about 1.8, approximately 2 millimeters. Next, we'll take a look at what kind of camera both of these frames support. Is it a micro or a mini size camera? Micro being 19 millimeters. As you can see here, the FlexRC Ascent holds the 19 millimeter camera size, or the micro size camera. One thing to note about this frame is it's got slots on the side for the camera, which means you can move the camera up towards the front of the frame or back to get more camera protection, which is very nice. That's one of the things I like about the FlexRC Ascent frames, is they're so versatile. They've got so much stack height space, you can put 3 or 4 stacks in here. As an example, if you wanted to use a run cam mini DVR, onboard DVR. You could stick that on top in addition to your normal three-board flight stack. You've actually got room for four boards in here if you wanted to go that way and have an onboard DVR. You've got room in these slots to move the camera back and forth, which also means you can actually, by doing so, you can increase or decrease the camera angle to basically whatever you want. That, in addition to the fact that it can hold 11XX to 15XX motors, this frame, these FlexRC Ascent frames are very versatile. Let's take a look at the camera size for the Aero. It also is designed to hold a micro 19 millimeter camera. This one, however, does not have slots. It's got a single hole. So that means you cannot move the camera back and forth in this one. As a matter of fact, let's take a look at the camera placement in this. I've got a Foxeer micro camera here, 19 by 19. So sticking this in the frame, aligning the holes, you can actually see that in this Aero frame, the camera's sticking out from the camera protection side plates. If that's a concern for you, then this may not be the frame for you. However, at the same time, these arms are so close together that they might actually provide protection for the camera. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. You'll have to decide that. These arms are only, motor to motor, they're 90 millimeters apart. From the tips, they're about 107 millimeters apart. So once again, you'll have to determine whether or not this is sufficient camera protection for you. Before you decide whether or not you want to purchase this hybrid frame. Lastly, we'll go ahead and take a look at the cost of both of these frames. The FlexRC Ascent comes in at $35, regular price. And the HGLRC Aero 3 Hybrid is $22.99, regular price. Keep in mind the FlexRC Ascent is more versatile with regards to the size of the flight stack that you put in here, as well as the camera protection, being able to move it forward and backwards in the frame, whereas the stack height on the HGLRC Aero is smaller and the camera protection isn't as good as you have in the FlexRC Ascent HD. So, those are the parameters that we compared on both of these frames. Here's where I need your input. Which of these frames, the Ascent or the Aero, do you think we should build out? If you think we should build the Ascent, just put the word Ascent in the comments below. If you think we should build the Aero, put the word Aero in the comments below. We'll go ahead and take all of your inputs into consideration as to which one of these nice frames we'll use to build out our micro FPV 3-inch quadcopter.
These are the parameters we just went over for two frames. These are also the same parameters we compiled for 31 different 3-inch quad frames from 21 different manufacturers, some well-known big companies, and some lesser-known boutique companies which you may not have heard of yet. And these are their quad frames. And we've got all the data for you on all of them, so you can compare them to each other on things like cost, weight, size, stack height space, width of plates as an indicator of durability, and so on. That way you can make a well-informed decision on what the best 3-inch frame is for your micro build. So grab your guide below and get ready to build your dream machine. Remember to subscribe, share this with your friends, thumbs up for good measure. We'll see you next time. Thanks for your time, and happy flying.